Hello and welcome again to MRigVAT's Learning. I am Sanjay Sharma, your learning facilitator in the series of videos posted to this channel. In the last video of the A Date with Programming series, you were introduced to pseudocodes and you learned to create a simple program by using pseudocodes. Most of the programs that need user interactions work on data that changes occasionally to quite frequently. In this video, you will learn about using variables, using data types, declaring variables of a data type, and using pseudocodes to create a program that uses variables. One of the eternal truths is that the change is the only constant in this universe. So is true with any business organization or an application program that you develop for the organization. As a result, when your program needs to interact with a user, it has to store data that it accepts from a user somewhere in the program. You store such data in small storages. Any content broadly consists of two categories of data: constant and variable. Data that changes rarely or occasionally is considered as constant. For example, a board displaying a name outside a house changes rarely or once in a while and therefore is a constant. However, the letterbox whose content changes almost daily is a variable. Similarly, on a website, the information about an organization changes once in a while. Such information is displayed in the form of constant. In the last video, you saw an example of displaying a constant value in a program. However, when a user is expected to interact with your program, you do not know what values the user would enter. For example, you never know which item and its quantity a user would require from your online shopping website. Therefore, such values are taken as variables in a program. What about the price? Do you think price is a constant value? Well, the answer to this question can either be yes or no. If the price of an item is expected to change only once in a while, such as price of a book that changes occasionally, then you can use it as a constant. However, if the price of an item is expected to change frequently, such as price of a share that might change every minute or so, then you must use it as a variable. Irrespective of a constant or a variable, values are either in the text or numeric form. In a program, you use a text form to display any alphanumeric content, which includes text as well as numbers, as a message or prompt to the user. However, you need specialized variables to hold data that you accept from the user. The type of data that you need to store in a variable defines its data type. Broadly, you can categorize data types as text and numeric. Numeric data can further be integers or decimal points. Therefore, you can use variables of three data types in a program, which are text, integer, and decimals. These are the three fundamental data types that are used across programming languages, and each language has its own convention to refer to these data types. All other data types available in various programming languages are ideally derivatives of these data types. Each data type has a memory requirement associated to it, whereas text has one byte associated to each character in the text, integer and decimal have 4 bytes associated to the number. Therefore, you should always consider the use of a variable before creating it, because memory of the computer is limited and you must use it to the optimum. You should use integer and decimal data types only if you have to perform any mathematical calculations on the variables. For example, to calculate amount to be paid, you need to multiply price by the quantity ordered. Therefore, you must use price and quantity as integer variables. However, for the house and street numbers in an address, you do not have to perform any mathematical calculations. Therefore, it is better to use these as text variables. Similarly, anything that you can calculate, you should avoid using a variable to store it, because whenever needed, you can always use the mathematical formula to get the value. This can avoid putting strain on the memory requirements of a program, not only by avoiding to create a variable, but also to update it whenever the values of other variables change. Before you use a variable in a program, you must declare it. This means the program creates the variable as soon as the statement is run. You can either declare a variable at the beginning of the program or just before you need the variable in the program. To declare a variable, you use a data type followed by the variable name. In most of the programming languages, you can create multiple variables of the same data type in a single statement. Even though you can use any name to create a variable, it is a best practice to use meaningful variable names. This makes sure that you know the reason for which you have created the variable. This not only avoids confusion, but also helps in understanding and debugging the program. For example, if you want to accept the room number and guest name, you can use room number, guest first name and guest last name as the variable names instead of NO and NM. Notice that the variable names must consist of a single word. Let us now create a program that accepts two numbers, swaps the values of the two and then displays the result. Write the program as shown in the scripting area. Program swap. Begin program. Integer first num second num temp. Display enter the first number. Accept first num. Display enter the second number. Accept second num. Temp is equal to first num. First num is equal to second num. Second num is equal to temp. Display the first number is. Display first num. Display the second number is. Display second num. End program. In this program, notice that we have used text in quotation marks to display constant values that are used to prompt and display message to the user. However, to accept and display a variable, you use the variable name without any quotation marks. Remember that variable names are case sensitive and should be used exactly as these are declared. Now let us summon our virtual memory board and evaluate the program with a dry run. As soon as you run the swap program, the computer reserves a memory block for the program which is enclosed between the begin program and end program statements. With the integer statement, the program declares and creates three variables, first num, second num and temp of integer type at random locations within the memory block allocated for the program. Now these chunks of memory are referred to with the respective names. We will use these memory chunks to store the values of the first and second numbers accepted from the user. Additionally, we will use the temporary variable temp to perform internal manipulations of data in the program. I have used integer data type for these variables because if a user enters a large number, text type of variable might consume more memory as compared to the integer type. As soon as the display statement is run, the program writes the enter the first number text in the memory, which is taken as an input by the display statement and displays it on the virtual display board. The memory associated with the display statement is then released for other statements of the program. When the accept statement is run, it waits for the user to input the number. As soon as the user enters a value, for example 1255, the accept statement takes it as an input and stores the value in the first num variable existing in the memory block reserved for the program. The memory associated with the accept statement is then released for other statements of the program. With the next display statement, the program writes enter the second number text in the memory, which the display statement takes as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. When the accept statement is run, it waits for the user to input the second number. As soon as the user enters a value, for example 209, the accept statement takes it as an input and stores the value in the second num variable. With the next statement, the program assigns the value of the first number to the temporary variable temp. Notice that now the first num and temp variable have the same value. When the next statement is run, the program assigns the value of the second num variable to the first num variable. Now both the first num and second num variables have the same value. However, the original value of the first num variable still exists in the temp variable. Notice that if we had not used the temp variable, we would have lost the value of the first num variable as soon as this statement is run. When the next statement is run, the program assigns the value of the temp variable to the second num variable. This completes the process of swapping the values of the first num and second num variables. When the display statement is run, the program writes the first number is text in the memory, which the display statement takes as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. The next display statement takes the first num variable as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. When the next display statement is run, the program writes the second number is text in the memory, which the display statement takes as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. The next display statement takes the second num variable as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. Notice that all constants and variables still exist in the memory block. Even though you can still access the variables in a program as many times as you want, you cannot access the constants existing in the memory because there is no reference to those memory chunks. However, you can refer to the memory chunks associated to the variables with the respective variable names. As soon as the end statement is run, the entire memory associated to the program is released for other activities of the computer. Now let's complete an exercise on data types and variables. In this video, we created a program to swap values of two integers by using three variables. Create a program to swap values of two integers, but this time you must use only two variables. Try creating this program at your own. I will post the solution to this problem statement at the end of the next video. You can compare your program with one available in that video. In this video, you learned about using variables, using data types, declaring variables of a data type, and using pseudocodes to create a program that uses variables. In the next video, you will learn about different types of operators. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed creating it, especially for you. If so, do not forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel, Let's Simplify Computers with Mrigvats Learning. Clicking notification, the bell icon will notify you about my new videos.